How's it going, everybody? Welcome to today's video, where I'll be ranking all of Def Leppard's studio albums by my personal favorites. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already for more of these great videos regularly. I also post original songs and song covers as well if you guys are interested in those. So coming in first on the list, we've got Def Leppard's debut album released in the year 1980. This one's titled On Through the Night, and it's going right up here in the S tier. Honestly, it took me quite a few years to get into this album, but it really helped start the band off in the hard rock and heavy metal genre with the likes of up-and-coming British rock bands at the time, such as Judas Priest and Iron Maiden. They went on to develop this raw sound into a more professional, perfected sound on their second album, which I will be discussing shortly. The only track on this album I think the average fan might possibly know is the song Wasted. So I'm going to go ahead and play for you guys a couple of my favorite underrated intros / guitar riffs and guitar solos from each of these albums, like I did in my last video. So first on the list, we have that song, Wasted. Check it out. Now here's the opening riff for the opening track of the album. This song's Rock Brigade. My pick for the most underrated guitar solo on this album is going to have to go to the final track titled Overture. Let's check it out. Okay, moving on to the next album, we have Def Leppard's 1981 release titled High and Dry. This one's going to go right up there above On Through the Night as one of my favorite Def Leppard albums. They took everything that was great from the first album and they built upon it even further to give it a more polished, professional sound. This is also the first Def Leppard album to feature producer Robert John Mutlange, who just came off of working on one of the most iconic rock albums a year earlier, producing AC/DC's Back in Black in the year 1980. So let's go ahead and check out a few of the underrated riffs and solos from this album. And the first one is gonna go to the song Let It Go. And songs on this album that the average fan might possibly know is Bringing On the Heartbreak, Let It Go, and Switch 625. Okay, next we've got the second track on the album, and this is another Hit and Run. such an iconic song. I love the guitarist's use of clean and distorted guitar tones to build and put different sections of the intro together. Then you have Rick Allen kicking ass on the drums in the background as well. So now we've got the third track on the album, which gives me massive AC/DC vibes, and this is the song High and Dry. I'm going to play the intro and the chorus riff, because on this song it was hard for me to choose which one I thought was the best. Here you go. Like I said, I just get such massive AC/DC vibes, and particularly from that track right there. So my pick for the most underrated guitar solo from this album is going to go to a track we just covered the intro on, and this is the second track, Another Hit and Run. I've always loved their use of shredding and melodic phases in different Def Leppard songs on the guitar to build a certain kind of mood and feeling with each guitar solo that makes it impactful. So let's go ahead and move on to Def Leppard's third studio album, released in the year 1983, which is none other than the album Pyromania. And for me, this is going right up here in the top of the S track. This is hands down my favorite Def Leppard album ever made. Hysteria and High and Dry are pretty close up there, but I've always had a certain nostalgia for this album. It was my dad's favorite album. He wore this album out on cassette and CD, and was my first experience in my life that I ever got into hearing this band. So a few of the tracks that the average fan would know on this album is going to be Photograph, Too Late for Love, Foolin', Rock of Ages, and then maybe Rock Rock Till You Drop. So let's go ahead and kick into what is one of the most underrated Def Leppard songs. I never understood why I didn't get it any radio airplay at all, because I think it's fantastic. And this is the song Coming Under Fire. What a badass song. Highly recommend checking that one out if any of you guys have never heard it. So we're going to move on to another underrated intro from this album, and this from the opening track titled Rock Rock Till You Drop. We'll be right back. Okay, my pick for the underrated guitar solo actually goes to the same song. Let's check it out. Like I said, there are different uses of melodic phrasing and shredding on guitar solos. Always make them very interesting to listen to and fun to enjoy. Now I'm about to play this one for you guys because not only is this one of my favorite Def Leppard songs, as far as the intro to, which I won't be playing here, but as far as their guitar solos, this is one of them for me. Love his use of pinch harmonics, the whammy bar doing dive bombs on that solo, which we haven't heard too often from Def Leppard, and then the way that the guitar solo builds as the drums and the music continue to build up and kick back into the bridge of the song. So let's go ahead and rank Def Leppard's fourth studio album, titled Hysteria, released in the year 1987. And this one's going right here in between Pyromania and High and Dry. Over the years, High and Dry has really grown on me. And so I'd say Hysteria and High and Dry are probably tied right there in the second place, with On Through the Night there at the third spot. Hysteria is just too iconic for me and nostalgic. A lot of the songs that I heard after Pyromania, like I said, my dad was a huge Pyromania fan. He always jammed out to it, but my mom was a big Hysteria fan. So anytime any of the Hysteria songs came on the radio, I got to kind of see two separate sides of Def Leppard. My dad's love for the hard rock, heavy metal side, then my mom's love for the kind of pop rock sound. And my pick for the underrated guitar riff on this album is going to go to the song Gods of War. And this album stacked with songs that the average fan will know. This includes the tracks Rocket, Animal, Love Bites, Pour Some Sugar on Me, Armageddon It, and Hysteria. So let's go ahead and check out the intro to Gods of War. Very cool little ambient intro there. We'll be right back. What a nice, epic, chill little intro for a song, building it up for a 6.5 minute song. Now, the next one is iconic. It's pretty popular. Almost everybody's going to know this one, but it's going to have to take my pick for one of the most badass intros to a rock song, and this is the song Rocket. I've always absolutely loved the intro of that song, even since I was a little kid. Never ceases to amaze me. So now let's go ahead and go over to the underrated guitar solo for this album from the opening track. This is the song Women. Just completely badass. We've got some nice melodic phrasing there for the solo, nothing too flashy, and then ends it with the dive bomb on with the whammy bar. Pretty cool. So let's go ahead and go to Def Leppard's fifth studio album, and this is Adrenalize, released in the year 1992. I'm gonna put this in the A tier. It's hard to compete with all the other albums in the S tier, but this is still a really good Def Leppard album. And so my picks for what the average fans would know off this album is Let's Get Rocked, Have You Ever Needed Someone So Bad, and then the song Heaven Is, which a lot of common fans might not know, but it's a good one that's definitely worth checking out. So my pick for the underrated guitar riff from this song is going to be from the track Tear It Down. Check it out. And then my pick for the underrated guitar solo is the second one from the track White Lightning. Okay, so let's go ahead and move on to the next album. And this is one that is technically not a studio album by Def Leppard. It's a compilation album, but it gives us a lot of previously unreleased content from the band so far. that I thought was a worthy addition to this list. So now we've got the 1993 release titled Retroactive, which is going right there behind Adrenalize in the A tier. There's a lot of different musical styles on this album that are nice to listen to for whichever Def Leppard fan you are. And this album includes one of my all-time favorite underrated Def Leppard songs, which is going to be featured in this album's most underrated guitar riff and solo. This is the song Desert Song. If you've never heard this one before, you have got to check it out. It's badass. Now we're going to go to the guitar solo on this song. Here it is. Always loved the musical style of that song. It reminds me of like a great mix in between of both Pyromania and Hysteria. It keeps the hard rock vibes of Pyromania, and in some of the choruses and vocals it adds that touch of Hysteria to it. In a way, I kind of wish some of the albums on Hysteria would have been more like that, tying into their hard rock roots. But still, overall, two great albums from the band, and then this song is definitely an underrated classic. So we're going to move on to Def Leppard's sixth studio album, and this is where things start to get a little rocky, boy, I'll tell you what. So, let me pull it back up here. Okay, so the 1996 release Slang, Def Leppard's sixth studio album's D tier. Not really for me, still a solid album. Too many hip-hoppy intros and just an overproduction of pop sound there. Def Leppard's seventh studio album, titled Euphoria, released in 1999, is going to go up in the B tier. A lot better of an album than Slang, and probably one of their strongest albums within the past 25-30 years. And I've got a couple of tracks from this album I'd like you guys to listen to. The most popular tracks that people know off this album would probably be the song Promises. And that's about it. So my pick for the favorite intro is from the song Paper Sun. My pick for the underrated guitar solo on this album is you have to go to the song Promises, which if you're an average Def Leppard fan, you haven't heard this song, you like the sounds of Hysteria, like the pop rock songs, definitely one worth checking out. Okay, now we're going to move on to Def Leppard's 8th studio album, titled X, released in the year 2002. And this is going to be another D album. I mean, it's still solid. None of these albums are terrible. Just not really any songs that the average fan would know. And most of the album is pretty forgettable, just like Slang. So we're going to go to Def Leppard's ninth studio album. And this is Yeah, which was released in 2006. I'm going to put this in the C tier. Definitely better than Slang or X. However, this is a complete album of cover songs, but I still like it better than Slang and X, as it has some memorable song covers such as Rock On by David Essex, 20th Century Boy by T-Rex, 10538 Overture by Electric Light Orchestra, ELO, and then No Matter What by Badfinger. Def Leppard doing some interesting takes on some classic rock songs and making them into their own version. And this was a good breath of fresh air compared to Slang or X. Def Leppard's 10th studio album, Songs from the Sparkle Lounge, is going to go right in here in the D tier, maybe above Slang. Also, what a stupid-ass name for an album. I'm going to go ahead and say that right now. One thing that really turned me off from this album when I first heard it when I was younger is their opening track is a collaboration with country artist, I think Tim McGraw. So Def Leppard just mixing their sound with a country artist's vocals just wasn't for me. I couldn't really get into the album after that. Still a decent album, but just not for me. Def Leppard's 11th studio album, self-titled by the name of Def Leppard. Always find it funny when bands do that. They'll take like their later album and make it self-titled. It's going to go in the C tier. It's definitely better than any of the albums in the D tier I put there. And it's more of a transition back to their hard rock and heavy metal roots. Unfortunately, most of the tracks are pretty forgettable, but the sound quality and the sound that they're going for in this album definitely step forward from everything in the D tier. Then, so we have Def Leppard's 12th studio album titled Diamond Star Halos, released in May of 2022. And I'm going to put this right at the top of the C tier. I got to see these guys live in concert for the first time in June 2022 when they were on the stadium tour with Motley Crue, Poison, Joan Jett. So it was cool being able to hear some of these songs from this album in their live performance with all their classic songs, helped me get a bit more appreciation to this new album. This new album's also more of a return to their hard rock roots, cutting down a little bit of the cheesiness of the band we've got for about the past 25 years. And me and my sister listen to this album a lot. We listened to it all the way home from Nashville that night when we drove back. And I think it's a pretty good album. And looking forward to see what they have to do next. Well, that's it for today's ranking video, guys. Let me know any bands you want me to cover down in the comments below. As always, love yourself, take care of each other, and I will catch you on the next video. Thanks for watching.